Alright.
Almost so we have talked about this like live stream.
Sounds good.
I'll be back. All Victoria, right. I had to take it.
Thank you. Tell Kennedy you stole it. It's yours. From now on. Here's the cords and here's the box. It's plugged in clear up there. Good luck. Thank you.
We're doing broilers right now.
Last set of broilers. Laying. They do egg layers first and then they do all the yeah, like the kids pull them out, talk to him, Judd handles it, gives it back to the kid, kid puts it back soon.
Okay, so when they do this side, so I know if you're not
going in. You can, yeah. Alright, good luck.
Thank you.
So this morning we had a rooster throwing contest for the roosters in the show, and Garrett Ball had the rooster that made the most noise.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, they were having. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Grant Tenley. I'm excited to be here judging birds down at the Louisa County Fair. We just went through a broiler class here. Very nice class of birds. All the birds are in good condition. They all weighed really well. Really the deciding factor here, I asked all the kids kind of similar questions, you know, what kind of housing they keep their birds in, what kind of feed, they feed their birds, how old the birds are, what they weigh, things like that. You know, we talked about some common problems with broilers. A lot of times on their feet and their hock joints, they'll get sores once they get to be very large. We had 9 pens here. All the kids kind of knew, you know, if they had roosters and hens, so that was good. There's not really too many issues there. The deciding factors for 1 through 9 for me was a little bit with the weights, you know, how close you can get the trio to weigh. There's going to be a little variance in all of them, it seems. And then it came down to just kind of cleanliness. You know, some overall, birds are very clean. I've definitely seen some fairs where they're maybe not as clean and they have more problems. I was really proud of all the kids. They didn't have any sores on their feet and legs very much at all. There was a few that were starting on some of the larger birds, but overall it wasn't a problem. Just keeping them clean from the time you wash them to the time I'm handling them, that's the biggest thing. I kind of was talking with the kids, you know, it's very hard to keep the birds pure snow white. So that's kind of what I was going for, I guess. But overall, it was all a very good group, and just kind of placed them based on all those factors combined, and then keeping them clean. So, but overall, everybody should be very proud of their projects, and they did a good job.
Thank you.
for the single broiler class, we just had one cockerel entry. Again, just kind of went along the basic stuff we talked about with the other broiler class. Nice clean bird. There's no sores on his feet or hock joints. He just kind of told me about, you know, how he keeps them, what he feeds them, and stuff like that. So very nice bird, and he got a blue ribbon. So keep up the good work.
Jonathan Ornstaff. That one was sponsored by Heather Love Independent Sensory Consultant. All of the exhibitors got blue ribbons. All right. We are now going to go back to the front page. And we're going to be doing dependent three layers. Production on the one single bird went to Asher Leopard.
Thank you. more important than ours?
What?
You're leaving at 3?
Yeah.
What's more important than ours?
Wouldn't you think last year's State Fair winner would bring birth to our county fair? And then she's just queen? What the heck?
Thank you.
watching, like, was somewhere to see.
The dog show, the camera somehow got flipped.
Who was looking at me for part of it.
Oh, really?
Like, that's not all. I did not want that.
You're like, I didn't say it.
Finish up the later class here. We have a couple old pens and one younger pen. Very nice birds. The pullets ended up winning. But overall, very clean. The exhibitors knew what color egg they laid. You know, they knew if the birds were in lay or not. They kind of knew what they were feeding them, what breed they were, some things like that. So overall, a good class. We're going to move on to the next class.
Single hen.
Yeah. Thank you. just got done judging our criminal entry and production class. A really neat class of birds. A lot of different breeds represented and a lot of different ages of birds. I kind of went through the kids, asked them the similar questions about maybe what they're feeding, how we're housing them, what color eggs they lay, what the breed is. Really, overall, everything was really clean. Some birds are just a little too young to be in production, and we kind of talked about how maybe next year the kids can get their birds a little bit earlier and they'll be closer to egg production through the show, and that will reflect in their placing. But it doesn't take anything away from the exhibitors and the birds because they're very healthy, very clean birds. The champion ended up being the ISA Brown sexton on the end there. She just kind of epitomizes what egg-producing birds should be. Good body, good feather condition. She's got good depth of carriage for egg production. Overall going to be a really good egg. Now we're going to move on to our next spot.
Thanks.
Yeah,
might as well. Okay. Thanks. Grab your water, do whatever. The best of the class egg production single handling with Eric Cooley. That award was sponsored by Premier
Lumber Line. Is that another bad thing? He won the 10-3, 10-1, and he's
not doing
it. Are we doing the egg?
We're doing eggs right now, yes. Now you're going to break. We're going to
work through the egg time now.
Now
we're going to
work through the egg time now.
Stand on that and take one from this side. it up.
I'm
anyway.
Last one,
Through the egg class, a variety of different eggs, all chicken eggs, different sizes, colors, eggs in different breeds. A couple of the kids had the pointy end up, and you always want the pointy end down, so we went over that. A couple of them had a little bit of manure on a couple of eggs, so that was something we went over, and then there was a couple of track eggs. So just something to consider, you know, you want them to be uniform in size. You want the air sac up and the pointy end down. You want them to be clean. You want them to be the same color and texture of shell. So it looks good if you can get it out of the same chicken. So on a mixed flock, you might have a little bit of a different dozen than somebody who, say, has all from the Marans or Brian Reds or something like that. Overall, the eggs on the plate, you can tell they're all fresh. They're all pretty nice on the plate, but we just kind of did some nitpicking, and that was what kind of set them apart, I guess. But overall, a pretty nice dozen by everybody, so good job.
Hey, dude. lot, man.
Awesome. Yes, you do. No, you don't. I'm sorry. You don't. You do. You got a thing that's taping right here or something. Oh, you're fine. You can stand right there. That's where your birds are. And just be front and center. You're okay.
Yeah, I can. There, then it will be like directly on you.
Thank you.
cousin, our son's cousin, our band from Feather Leg class. A really nice class. We had four coaches and five trophies. Overall, a couple of the trophies just need a little more time, a little more maturity. The post, not only the coaches on the end, were very good type and condition. We ended up going with one of the boys for champion of Feather Leg class. Talked to the young lady about her buff coaching. A nice overall bird, just the buff color matters. It's a little harder to get polluted when they run out in the sunlight. We got to keep them indoors, out of the sun, and keep that color pattern dark or buff, I guess you would say. And then we talked a little bit about height on a hatchery bird versus a black. They're just a little different height for the green. The buck female doesn't have that globular round, you don't call them a circle. She just didn't have that. But overall, good class, and we'll keep moving on.
Your
$24.